Hi guys, this is Awhobiwom. Thank you for stopping by. Today we are going shopping, so we're going like grocery shopping. I want to do like my monthly shopping today, and I want to take you along with me so you could see the stuff I'm going to buy, and then after that we would come and sit down and talk about the cost of living or how much you need to spend or how much you can spend in Poland as just one person. So we're going to be going to Auchan. Auchan is one of those big supermarkets that I had mentioned in my other videos. I usually like to go to Auchan because it has a lot of products, like different brands, and you get to choose which brand you want, which most times I always buy Auchan products because they are always cheaper. But I buy in bulk there as well because it would serve me for the entire month. So that's how I shop. In situations where I run out, I just quickly go to be a drunker not so far from where I live, or Jabka. Come along with me and I will show you what today is going to be about.
your refund? Yadan kilo.
Back, and the total amount of money that we have spent here today is 191 zloty 47 grosze. So this amount is about 19,000 naira in terms of Nigerian currency. So I'm just going to give a breakdown of how you would spend your money if you're a student and you don't have like enough money and just live life on a budget. And also I would talk about how much I spend. I would use myself as an example, like the way I was spending when I was still in uni and how I'm spending now after uni. Okay, so when I first came, my first semester I wasn't working, so I did not have any job whatsoever. I was trying to focus on my studies because this girl wanted to do well in school. At the time I didn't want anything that would distract me from school, so I gave myself that one semester off from doing anything. And plus I was just getting here, I needed to get used to everything. So back from home I had like done like a budget of, okay, how much would I live on if I do not get a job in 7 months. So I had like done a proper budget for 7 months. So 7 months was my target. Like I was not going to work for 7 months. That was, if worst came to worst. So how will we spend our money? So basically, as a student, you'll be living in the student apartments or student dormitories. These are the cheaper ones. So let's just work with an average of between 550 zloty to 700 zloty as your rent. So this would be like your monthly rent. So your rent covers your media. So your media is like your electricity bill, your water bill, and your internet. So all these are enclosed in that 550 to 700 zloty mark that we are using today. And from what you saw in when we went to the store, you saw that I have been able to buy like a lot of stuff that can actually last me. I try to go to Auchan because when you get to Auchan with meat, you can buy per kilogram and this is cheaper. So I'm more like a chicken and turkey person. So with chicken and turkey, is less, like it's less expensive than the normal pork, beef and all that other meat out there. So it depends on what your preference is. So in my case, I just bought chicken and turkey, so this would last me for a very long time. And I bought 2 kilograms of meat, so I would be able to ration it. Also, I did not buy some items like some spices because I already have this. So some months would be different. There are some months that you would buy more and there are some months that you buy less. I still have some leftover of some items, so that's why I didn't buy some items. Our rent, we've calculated our rent to be 550 to 700 zloty monthly. And your spending maximum, you should try as much as possible. As a student, you should try as much as possible to maintain 200 zloty a month budget for food. So yes, for food, for groceries, everything inside. Because you saw I bought even detergents for washing and bathing, shower gel and all that. So this is in the 200 zloty. That's why I suggested that you should always try to go to stores that have different brands so you can compare prices and buy the cheaper brands. For now, you're not earning any money. You're coming from your home country, so I'm sure your head is doing all the maths in your
in your currency. Like when I came, I would see pepper, for example. And then, okay, because there are different peppers. So the normal bell peppers, those ones are not so expensive. But because I'm Nigerian and I like spicy food, I was looking for the normal peppers that we use back home. And these peppers are, they're expensive. So when I look at this small quantity of pepper and I'm like, this pepper, I'm supposed to pay 9 zloty for this pepper. Back in Nigeria, this is like 100 naira pepper. And I'm here paying like 900 naira for this pepper. So everything, your head will be doing maths in naira or in whatever home currency you're coming from. So I understand. But as soon as you start earning money in zloty, trust me, you would forget about whatever conversion rates and you'll be buying things based on how much they cost here and based on zloty. So you wouldn't be doing those mathematics in your head. Another thing that we would spend money on monthly is definitely going to be tickets. I had spoken about this before. I always advise to buy bulk tickets, so like 5 months. But as a result of the pandemic, we are staying at home. So you rarely go out. So if you even buy 5 months worth of tickets, it's probably going to be a waste. So that's why I only buy when I'm going out, which is maybe in a month. I don't know how many times I go out anymore. And plus we have like a semi-lockdown right now. So the price of the tickets as a student in Wrocław, as a student, if you're paying 30 days, so I've written it down, if you're paying for tickets for 30 days, it's valid for 49 zloty, and if you're paying for 5 months, this is 185 zloty. So do the math. It's always better to buy at, for 5 months than to buy for 1 month. But then if you're a normal person, that's, sorry, if you're a normal person, because on the train you can see U and N. U is like the discounted tickets for university students or for students, while N is the normal ticket. So normal tickets for people who are not students is 98 zloty for 30 days, all lines, and 370 zloty. You can imagine how much I'm going to be spending on train tickets now because I am no longer a student. Anyways, so like I was saying, I advise that you take advantage of your students' benefits that you have right now. All the discounts that come as a student, you just have to use them. Also, clothes, things like clothes and other miscellaneous. You know, it's not every month you buy clothes. So we can just decide to give clothes a certain amount of money, and it's not a reoccurring, it's not going to be a reoccurring cost. So it just depends on the kind of clothes you want to buy. But as a student, I would always advise to take advantage of the sales. Like you buy your winter clothes in summer and you buy your summer clothes in winter. What do I mean? By summer, all the winter clothes will be out on sale. Like nobody wants to buy sweaters and all those jackets in summer because it's winter, it's summer, everybody wants to like get rid of all the big clothes. So that is the time for you to go and buy all your sweaters. Like this sweater I'm wearing, for example, I remember when I was getting it, I think I got it for 19.99 zloty as on sale. Meanwhile, when it wasn't on sale, when it was in normal, like the normal price was 49.99. So imagine that, from 4.99 and I got it at 19.99. So that is how you take advantage of the seasons and the sales. So if I'm going to be calculating 700 for rent, 200 for groceries, and 49 zloty for train, that brings us to a total of 949 zloty monthly on the month. That is if your rent is 700, but if you have like a lower rent, you would add it up. And then on the months that, like I said, on the months that you buy clothes, this might go higher. And you just have to be very conscious of how much you spend. So with 1,000 zloty monthly, you can live comfortably, pay your rent, have everything, internet and what have you. Because so far as you have internet connected, you can definitely get on YouTube and watch whatever or find whatever movies you have online to watch. But if you add like Netflix subscription and all these other things, you know your money is going to keep going higher. Now that I am a worker, I had to move out of the school dormitory. So I had to get an apartment that was more expensive. So even apartments, it depends on what you want. If you want like a studio flat or you want like a shared apartment, it all depends on how much you're willing to spend. Anyways, I'm able to pay my rent. I'm able to save every month. I'm able to still go grocery shopping, and I'm still shopping as though I'm a student. But the good thing is now I can, every now and then I can take myself out. I can spend more money on myself. I'm no longer conscious of the money I'm spending. Not like I'm not conscious. What I mean is I have a budget. I know that I divide the earnings I'm making, I divide it into a certain percentage, and I work based on these percentages. So in summary, or in a nutshell of everything I have said here today, as a student, you can budget 1,000 zloty and work comfortably with 1,000 zloty for each month. And 1,000 zloty is like 100,000 naira. Some people go lower than that, some people go higher than that. It all depends on you. But at the end of the day, you just have to try to find the balance and make sure that you're not overspending and you're able to minimize cost. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for coming along with me on this vlog / sit down. So this was like a mixture of a sit down / vlog. So thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Do not forget, if you've not subscribed, please try to subscribe and also hit the notification bell, so as soon as I upload, you would get the notification. Take care, stay safe. I wish you a nice day. Bye bye.